I'm going to show you how to turn your wand that you made from our tutorial video on DIY Harry Potter magical wands into a Harry Potter magical wand that lights up. If you haven't watched our tutorial on DIY wands, go back and watch our tutorial on DIY Harry Potter magical wands using paper and tape. The essentials to make your light up wand would be the paper wand that you made. You need to make them a little larger so that the battery would fit right in here. Need wires. I like to use solid wires rather than stranded wires. Some sort of button. You see I have three different types of buttons here. I'm going to use actually the smaller button right here. You need an LED. I'm using a watch battery, which is also known as a CR2032. Battery, wire strippers, and a wire cutter. And this is for the essentials, but the way I'm going to make it, I'm actually going to solder the wires onto the button, and I'm also going to use a battery pack for the wand that I am creating. Instead of soldering, you could just actually use electrical tape to tape the wire onto the LED, onto the button, which might be a little difficult, and around the battery. And I will explain as I go along how you would do that with electrical tape rather than by soldering. And I'm also going to use heat shrink tubing rather than electrical tape to make sure it's more secure. So if you happen to have heat shrink tubing and you know how to solder, you could follow along exactly the way I do it in this tutorial. The first thing you're going to determine is where to place your button. You'll place your hand on your wand and identify where it's comfortable for your thumb to sit. Luckily, mine happens to sit right on this tape, so this is where I'll cut my opening for the button. If you have an X-Acto knife or a box cutter, you could cut your box here. What's easier is if you happen to have a soldering iron, you could actually burn a hole to the size you need. Next, you'll cut your wires a little longer than your wand, as you could see here. And that way, if you need to shorten, you have that option to shorten. But it's better to have longer wires than shorter wires. I'm soldering the red wire and the black wire to the battery pack. Next, I insulate the wires using heat shrink tubing and a heat gun. If you don't happen to have solder or a soldering iron, what you could do is you could place the battery in between the two wires. As such, making sure you strip the wires so that the metal of the wires are touching each side of the battery, and you tape it with electrical tape, and make sure you tape it quite well so it secures and it remains in contact with the battery. On an LED, you'll have two wires. Hopefully you have one longer wire and one shorter wire. The longer wire is the positive lead, known as the anode, and the shorter wire is the negative lead, known as the cathode. And what you're going to do, you're going to either tape these down using electrical tape, or you could solder them and then wrap them with electrical tape, or put heat shrink tubing over these wires. Make sure the wire that connects to the negative end of the battery pack is touching the negative or shorter lead on the LED, and the wire that connects to the positive end of the battery pack is touching the positive or longer lead on the LED. Also remember to place the heat shrink tubing on the wires before soldering the LED to the wires. To identify where to cut one of the wires for the button, insert your wire LED first from the handle end of the wand and place it all the way in until the battery pack or your battery sits inside the handle. Then fish out one of the wires where you place the hole for the button, and you can use a bent paper clip or tweezers to help. Clip the wire where they come out of the button hole. Pull out the wires and the LED from the handle end. Alternatively, you can just gauge where the wire aligns with the buttonhole without putting in the LED and wires into the wand. You will strip the ends of the clipped wire, then you will solder the button to both clipped wires, or you can use electrical tape to secure the wires to the button. You will insert the entire LED button battery assembly into the wand from the handle LED end first. You will fish out the button where you place the hole for the button. And again, you could use a bent paper clip or tweezers to help. If you only secured the button using electrical tape, take care to not remove the connection between the button and the wires. If you have a hot glue gun, you can glue the button so it doesn't fall inside the hole when you press the button. And you can also secure the light to the top of the wand using the hot glue gun. Next, ensure that the light lights up when you press the button. And finally, you can decorate your wand with the hot glue, paint, decorative tape, whatever you have on hand.
We would love for you to share your finished wands with us on Facebook and Instagram. We are adding new videos every week that you could do at home or even in your own classroom. Make sure to like our video, share, and subscribe to our channel.